Hi friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and I'm here with a question. Are you a PhD scholar and worried about how you are going to submit your PhD thesis? I can figure out that some of you who are watching this video are confused about your PhD thesis. Your guides don't help you so much and deadlines are near. You're still figuring out how to write a research paper, how to complete your PhD thesis in such a manner that it would not be rejected on the day of the jury. If all these questions are in your mind, then don't worry, you are absolutely at the right place. In this video, I'm going to give you a step-by-step guide on how to write a perfect research paper and a perfect PhD thesis. I'm also going to talk about do's and don'ts that you must remember while you are writing a PhD thesis. And in this video, I'm pretty sure that by the end of the video, you will have a clear-cut idea of how to write a PhD thesis quickly and easily. So if you are ready, let's get started. When you have decided to write a perfect PhD thesis, the first and foremost thing that you must understand here is to follow a universal format. Understand guys, PhD thesis is very different from creative writing. It's academic writing where there's a set format that you must adhere to. If you don't follow that format, then there are good chances that your thesis would be rejected. So unlike a creative writing where you make your imagination go wild and you can write anything anywhere without following any set format, in case of a PhD thesis, there's a universally accepted format, and in the same format, you need to draft your PhD thesis. In this video, I'm going to talk about all the different pages that you need to add in your PhD thesis and what all content would be a part of those pages, what are the things which you should not write in a particular page, and what is a particular format that you need to follow. The first important page is the title page. Now, title page would carry the title of your PhD thesis. Just below the title, you would have the name of your guide and the name of the scholar, that is you. And finally, towards the end, there would be the logo of university and the name of the university from where you're doing your PhD. Now, this same format you can copy from some other PhD thesis, okay, or else you can just have a look at different PhD thesis formats and then make your title page accordingly. The next page is declaration. Declaration, we all know, is basically a page where you declare that you have worked in this thesis yourself. You have not copied it. You have not got yourself involved in any illegal or unauthorized practices. Then after the declaration page is the certificate page, a certificate which you get from the university site and a certificate which is given to you by the guide telling that you have done this PhD under this guide and you have done it to the best of your knowledge. After the certificate page, you have another page attached. Now this page is important because this page contains abstract. Now what is abstract? Abstract is basically a summary, okay, of your PhD. We would not specifically say it's a summary. We would say it's basically an introduction which is going to tell other scholars what your PhD is all about. If you've gone to the websites like ResearchGate or ShodhGanga, you must have figured out that they have this abstract, and just below the abstract they have all the download links for the PhD thesis. Only after reading the abstract you can understand whether you would like to actually read a 250 page PhD thesis or not. So just like if you go to a bookstore, you have a habit of looking at the backside summary of the book. In the similar fashion, the backside summary synopsis is the abstract in case of a PhD thesis. After abstract, you have another important page, which we know as acknowledgement. Now, what is acknowledgement? Acknowledgement is another page which you attach in your PhD thesis, which talks about people who have helped you in this particular PhD thesis, and you're just giving a token of thanks to all those people who have helped you in your thesis. Finally, you have the index, which is known as content. Now, on this content page, you talk about all the chapters. Now, a PhD thesis should ideally contain 4 to 6 chapters. The first chapter would definitely be an introduction, last would be conclusion, okay, and each chapter will also have introduction and conclusion. So in spite of the fact that you are already having an introduction and conclusion chapter, every chapter will in itself have introduction and conclusion. Also remember that the ideal length of a chapter should be somewhere around 40 to 60 pages long. So after having all these pages, you finally land on to the content page from where your actual body of thesis starts. So in the content page, you have a chapterization of your PhD thesis, and ideally it should be somewhere around 4 to 6 chapters. Now let's take an example. Suppose you have divided your PhD thesis in 6 chapters. So ideally the first chapter should be introduction. Now what are the things that you're going to include in the introduction? In introduction, you're going to first talk about the title and you're going to justify the title. You're going to talk about the review of literature, and after talking about review of literature, you're going to tell this jury why you have selected this topic. You are going to highlight the research gap, and accordingly you're going to justify your topic. Now after you have talked about review of literature, the next thing that you need to talk about in introduction is aims and objective. Now a lot of people have found that they get confused between aims and objective. They consider both of them to be same. No, aim basically means a broad goal that you wish to accomplish towards the end of the research, whereas objectives are specific goals which will help you to attain the aim. So aim is a broad goal, objectives are smaller steps that you are going to take in order to achieve the aim. So you are going to talk about aims and objectives in the introduction section. Also you are going to mention all the theories and the theorists that you will be looking into in the course of the research. So if you are talking about a tragedy in your PhD thesis, you are going to talk about Aristotle's Poetics and the theory of tragedy. Okay, that would become the theoretical base of your research. Or if you are talking about Indian mythology, so maybe you can look at Roland Barthes' mythologies. If you are looking at a work from Marx's point of view in your research, then you are going to talk about Karl Marx and Communist Manifesto. So all these theoretical things that will help you to analyze and interpret the text that you are researching on would be included in the introduction section. Now, after introduction, you come on to the next chapters. In the next chapters, you're going to talk about the different interpretations that you are drawing in your research. Suppose if I take a topic like Quest of Self-Discovery, a comparative study of female protagonist in Dear Zindagi and Eat, Pray, Love. If this is my research topic, then my next chapter after introduction would be psychoanalytical analysis of the movie Dear Zindagi, in which I would going to look at the character of Kyra, and I'm going to also look at the dreams and Sigmund Freud's theory of dream. I can also look at the talk therapy that happens between main character Kyra and her doctor Jahangir Khan. So all these things would be incorporated in the second chapter, where I'm going to specifically talk about psychoanalytical analysis of the movie Dear Zindagi. The next chapter would be psychoanalytical analysis of Eat, Pray, Love. Now this is a beautiful movie which is based on a book, okay, and the movie is based on life of a girl who is divorcee. The role is played by Julia Roberts. She goes to 3 countries. She first goes to Italy. There she eats a lot and tries to forget all the past baggage, emotional baggage. Then she comes to India, where she gets associated with an ashram and gets herself into meditation. And finally she goes to Bali, where she finds her true self and true love. So I'm going to track the entire journey and look at the journey from the perspective of psychoanalytical criticism through the theories given by Sigmund Freud and Carl Jung, and I'm going to see how I can interpret the movie in a totally different manner by looking at the quest of self-discovery. In the fourth chapter, after talking about introduction, psychoanalytical analysis of Dear Zindagi and Eat, Pray, Love, in the fourth chapter, I'm going to talk about comparison of these two works. I'm going to look at both the works, Dear Zindagi and Eat, Pray, Love, and see what are the similarity between the two characters. And I'm going to look at feminism in this particular chapter and see how feminist study can also be revealing in this case and can also give us new interpretations of the two works that I'm taking. And finally, I'll land up to the last chapter, which is conclusion. Now guys, what you need to understand here is that conclusion doesn't include summary of all the previous chapters. No, conclusion will include research aims and objectives and how we have achieved it in the entire research. Also, conclusion will include any research gap which is left so that we can give a scope to further researchers. I can also suggest to further researchers what are other things that you can take up from this particular topic. Also, I'm going to talk about hurdles which I faced during my research. All these things would be included in the conclusion chapter. Conclusion chapter doesn't mean picking up few lines from each chapter and summarizing it. That is not what conclusion means. Also remember, in all these chapters, you should also have introduction and conclusion. In the introduction area, you're going to talk about what you're going to deal in the entire chapter. Okay, and finally in the conclusion, you're going to talk about all the findings or all the major interpretation that you devised. So this is how a perfect research plan should be made, and this is how chapterization should move forward. Now that you have made the main body of thesis, you come to the end of your research where you would include two things. The first one is bibliography and second is appendix. Now, what is bibliography? In my past video where I was talking about how to write a research proposal, I have already discussed bibliography in detail. Bibliography is basically the area where you write all the sources or all the works that you have referred during the course of the research. Bibliography is divided in two parts. One is primary sources and the other one is secondary sources. In primary sources, you're going to write the books or movies or any work which is the main concern of your thesis. For example, the example that I've taken in this particular video is the criticism of Dear Zindagi and Eat, Pray, Love. So the primary sources which I would write in the bibliography would be the movie Dear Zindagi and the movie Eat, Pray, Love. Whereas in the secondary section, I'm going to incorporate all the other works, other articles, any newspaper ad or maybe any television ad or any article in newspaper which I have referred in my PhD thesis. So all those things would come in the secondary sources. So if I have used mythologies by Roland Barthes, or if I've used the theory of interpretation of dream by Sigmund Freud, all these works would be mentioned in the secondary sources under bibliography. Understand the fact that bibliography is the most important part of research these days, because most of the questions that you will be asked on the day of the jury would be from bibliography. So never copy and paste bibliography from some other research work, because if you are not able to answer the questions which have been asked from your bibliography, you will be in trouble. Finally, after bibliography comes appendix. What is appendix? Appendix is the area which will contain tables, graphs, pictures, charts, which has been referred in your particular thesis. Suppose if I'm doing a research on graphics in children literature, I would be using images from Lewis Carroll's Adventures of Alice in the Wonderland, or Through the Looking Glass, or Twinkle Twinkle and the images associated with that nursery rhyme. All these images would not come in the main body of research, the main body of PhD thesis. In all the 5-6 chapters in which you have actually analyzed all these graphic novels or you have analyzed children literature, you can never add pictures. All the pictures would be added in the appendix and would be referred in the main text in brackets appendix 1. Okay. Now, in the appendix, you would also include if you have used any questionnaire or interview or case study format. So all those schedules, interview schedule, observation schedule, questionnaire schedule would be attached in appendix. Understand the fact I have seen a lot of researchers being rejected just because they have added all these tables in the main body of the thesis, the main body of research paper, rather than adding it in the appendix. So never make this mistake. All the tables, graphs, charts, pictures, graphics should be included in appendix. So bibliography and appendix are two areas where you need to be a bit cautious, because most of the people make these two areas towards the end. Maybe they try to finalize it within a day or two, and they make a lot of errors because of which their entire thesis is rejected. So make sure that you start working on appendix and bibliography from day one of your PhD thesis. I think I've exceeded the time limit of this video, and I don't want this video to get boring any further. So I would be talking about do's and don'ts that you need to keep in mind while writing a research paper or PhD thesis in my next video. So stay tuned if you want to get notified about the next video. It's time for you to subscribe to the channel and also hit the bell icon so that next time when I come online, you get a notification right on your phone. Apart from that, I'm running a free GoNet quiz on all the social media platforms. So feel free to subscribe and follow me on all different social media platforms. The link of all these platforms are given in the description box below. If you've not visited our website, arpitakarwa.com, then I think you should do it right now, because we are running a fabulous UGC NET online course specifically for English literature students. We have already uploaded all the previous year papers for free on the website. Apart from that, a list of 700 most important writers and theorists are given for free on our website. So if you are struggling with your preparation, then it's time to just visit the website so that you have all your doubts clarified. So with that note, I would like to take your leave. We are going to meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.